Going on, you guys. Gio here from the Fandom United podcast, and I want to talk about this article from Sean O'Connell on Cinema Blend about Zack Snyder calling out the fakers who hated on his Justice League. So, yep, we're about to get some Zack Snyder clap back. He's going to let out some steam, and I'm definitely looking forward to see what he has to say. So, in case you're unaware of all of this, so Sean O'Connell is writing a book about the Release the Snyder Cut movement that made this upcoming Justice League movie possible. And he got the privilege of interviewing the director, Zack Snyder, who left the project back in 2017 and has since then, well, I think ever since his start of his film career, has been kind of a controversial figure. People love him or people hate him. There seems to be no in between. But yeah, so Sean O'Connell released part of his interview with Zack Snyder on the subject of toxic fandom and dealing with haters and trolls on the internet. Not just fans, but also some journalists. Let's read some of the quotes here. All right, this first one from Zack Snyder. "I just think that's sour grapes. There really is no other way to say it. We know the people who were the architects of that narrative, and it's pretty obvious what their agenda is. Those are people that I've been held back from confronting by wiser people in the room, because I'd love to get at some of these characters. Some direct conversation would be nice. Just to say, one, you don't know shit about what you're talking about, and we can break down everything they've ever said. I can make a list. There's a few of these guys where I could just get a list of everything they've ever said that they thought was right, and I could tell them every single thing they've said wrong." Now, this is the first of two quotes here. I want to stop because if you've been following Zack Snyder like I have, following his career, especially in the DC universe with Justice League, the Snyder Cut, you know that there's a lot of truth here. And I'll bring up one example. This is a tweet that I screenshotted. It happened right before DC Fandom, right before his trailer, the first trailer for the announced Snyder Cut was going to release. Some critic, some well-known, respected critic in Hollywood, commented on a leaked trailer and said this. So that trailer for the Snyder Cut of Justice League looks like the same movie. Lots of deleted scenes from the marketing campaign, but otherwise it looks like alternate takes of the existing scenes. Zack Snyder commented, "You said you enjoy the theatrical cut of Justice League like you enjoy your Saturday morning cartoons. Well, this is made for grown-ups, so you're not in the demographic. Also, cool of you to comment on a leaked teaser." He's calling out a respected journalist, a professional, for commenting on Twitter about a leaked teaser that he happened to not know was a fake. Because look, in his words, just the Snyder Cut of Justice League looks like the same movie. Really? This trailer? Looks like the same movie in 2017? That's what you're saying? No. Talking out his ass. And I blacked out, I'm not going to say who, but that's just one example of what this director has been dealing with for years. And you know what? I'm happy. I'm happy that he's finally getting to let out some steam in this book. It makes me even more excited to read the book. Anyways, let's continue. That was one of two quotes. And in this one, he talks about toxic fandom and how people are so quick to call this fandom, which I consider myself a part of, toxic in general. Here's what he says. "And so, in what world do you have any credibility anywhere to anyone? I would love the opportunity to just say to the world, to the fandom in general, who these fakers are and what should be done to them or with them. It's a bunch of BS. In regards to that toxic fandom, or it's a win for toxic fandom, again, in what world does this toxic fandom raise hundreds of thousands of dollars for suicide prevention? How is that toxic fandom? They've probably achieved more than any other fan base and done more good than any other group, so I don't understand. And you know what? Neither do I. Neither do I. Okay, now that's not to say that there isn't toxic fans in every fandom. There is, okay? Remember when The Force Awakens came out, a movie that was very well received compared to the other two in that sequel trilogy, Star Wars? Toxic fans all over the place because they felt it was a carbon copy of the fourth movie, and it forced so many things. And you know what? Maybe some of it, they're correct about some of it, but still. And in this one, especially the Snyder Cut fandom, absolutely. There's absolutely some toxic fans in there. Fans that don't want other people to watch the movie because they felt a certain way about the Snyder Cut at first, but have since come around and become a fan of this movement and this movie. And you know what? If you're one of those people who are now a fan of the movie and the movement who weren't at first, you know what? I welcome you. I welcome you because you are one more voice, one more pair of eyes that will watch this movie and give an honest opinion and be open to the possibility of it being a movie that you may enjoy. I'm glad you came around. And you know, it's no surprise. I'm not breaking any new ground here. There's toxic fans in every group. Every group has their cobas. Every group has their cobas. Every fandom has their cobas. What do I mean by coba? You know, Coba from the Planet of the Apes movies. Not to compare people to apes or, you know, fandoms to apes. That's not what I'm getting at here. This is what I'm saying. I'm talking about the emotional aspect, okay? Coba was somebody who was tortured both physically, mentally, emotionally, tortured in every way in those movies. And he was somebody who didn't know how to forgive. He didn't know especially how to forget. Now, you should never forget. You should never forget the words that someone says, but you can forgive. And in that example, hopefully it's a good example. It's one that I could come up with right now. But yeah, toxic fans are coba. They were probably cyberbullied a lot. They were laughed at. They were laughed at probably in their small circles. They were laughed at online. People that they look to for movie news, opinions, people who claim to be fans just like them, probably laughed at the stuff that they were rooting for. You know, you'd think I didn't have people who thought, you know, Gio, you're silly. Okay. Snyder Cut's never coming out. It's never happening. I've been laughed at before. Please, I've been trolled before. And yeah, some of them may have been jokes, but there were times where I took that to heart because there's just, you know, it's tough sometimes. It really is. And the reason I brought up Coba here is because Coba is somebody who was, you know, like I said, he's very much scarred and he has a tough time forgiving. And not that anybody should forget, you know, don't forget. But every fandom has its toxic fans. And you know what? Those small voices should not, be a representation of what these fandoms are, okay, and what their accomplishments have been. Again, I am so happy to be part of this fandom that raised hundreds of thousands of dollars for the American Foundation of Suicide Prevention. Okay, we not only championed the movement and called for the director's cut of a movie, but did something very charitable, very noble, and I'm so proud of all of you out there. But the moral of the video is, yes, there are toxic fans in every fandom, but don't let them be, the face, the voice of the overall population. Anyways, that's all I gotta say, guys. Appreciate you tuning into the video. Don't be toxic out there, okay? It's okay to have different opinions as long as we share them with some kind of respect and decency. Anyways, name's Gio from the Fandom United podcast. Appreciate your time. Appreciate the subscription. Let me know your thoughts on all this, and I'll catch you guys at the end of the week with another podcast.